The motivations for PBD, what is PBD, why PBD, notable PBD projects, and lastly, some concluding remarks. Introductions. Okay, this is our typical Metro Manila skyline. And according to the Philippine Statistics Authority, the closing of the second quarter of year 2016, the construction activities reached about 40,000 activities, and the value is about almost 60 billion pesos. So the value is about 60 billion. Now here are the tallest, 20 tallest building in the Philippines. We're in 70% of which were actually designed by our company. So closing references to the structural design. We have the National Structural Codes of the Philippines. We have the building codes requirement for structural concrete and commentary. And for steel, we're using the steel construction manual. The limitations of the codes. The NSCP 2010 actually allows only for three types of structural system. One is the pure frames. The other one is a pure wall system, but it's only limited now to 75 meters. And the other one now is the combinations of shear walls plus the pure frames, where we call it a dual system. The problem with our seismic provisions now, it is actually still based on UBC 1997, wherein this UBC 1997 is already replaced by IBC in the United States. The reason for that is because of the okay, the codes are basically developed for buildings less than 50 meters. They permit a limited number of structural systems. There is no provisions for framing system appropriate for tall buildings. They are based on elastic method analysis. They are prescriptive in nature, no explicit check on outcome. They enforce uniform detailing. They enforce unreasonable demand distributions. And they do not take advantage of the recent powerful computing tools. Other challenges. As mentioned earlier, the NSCP 2010, the provisions of which regarding the seismic provisions is actually based on UBC 1997, wherein we're actually stuck now with this 1997 response spectrum. And we all know that the Philippines is actually located within the Ring of Fire, because it's actually one of the most active seismic country in the world, having the Philippine crest on the right and then the Manila crest on the left. And also the Marikina Valley Fault Line, which is only about less than 10 kilometers from the urban city. And these are the 10 strongest earthquakes that actually hit Manila over the Philippines. And also aside from that, we have to deal with now with the effect of typhoon, where we actually average about 54 typhoons in a year. Other challenges is, for example, the provisions of the code saying that for pre-stressed members, they're not allowed to resist 100% of the total lateral loads, that they can only resist now about 20%. But the code also says that, realizes that there's actually limitations on their provisions, and that is the reason why it actually offered us certain alternative system and method of analysis. It says here that alternative lateral force procedure using rational analysis based on well-established principle of mechanics may be used in lieu of those prescribed in these provisions. So basically, we're actually giving out some leeway in terms of doing now an alternative force lateral method instead of that prescriptive response spectrum analysis. So it says here that also for nonlinear time analysis, where we use it now for PVD, we're also allowed to do this, and it says that the provisions of these codes are not intended to prevent the use of any material, alternate design, or method of construction not specifically described by this code, provided any alternate has been permitted and its use authorized by the building official. As mentioned earlier, because of the lack of accessible spectral map in the Philippines, we as a C-squared company, we have to commission now the services of a consultant in order to do now the seismic site study now for the whole of Metro Manila, and we call it now the C-squared seismic mapper. Where if you try to locate now your project, for example, in Makati, and then it actually gives you now this three level of earthquake, the SLE, the DBE, as well as MCE. If, for example, now you have now a project down in Manila, then again, it actually shows you now the three level of earthquake. Similarly, if you actually have now a project in Quezon City, it will also give you now the three level of earthquake. And likewise, for example, now on soft area like Manila, okay, so why PVD? We're saying that the lack of explicit performance in the design code, it requires the designer to assess building performance under heavy shaking to identify unsafe design, and also enable us to meet the code restriction in order to ensure safe and cost-effective design. What is PVD? It actually check now multiple performance level. It checks out the multiple seismic events are applied. We utilize nonlinear analysis, detailed global acceptance criteria for structural elements as well as for non-structural elements, and detailed global acceptance criteria indicates element by element checking whether the overall system factor R that is normally used now for code-based design approach. Under PVD, we are now checking now the performance of the building under three level of earthquake. One is the frequent service earthquake, which has a return period of about 72 years. Design-based earthquake, return period of 500 years. And then the MCE level, which has a return period of 2,500 years. Why PVD? Buildings are getting taller. Buildings are getting more complicated. You have now this very irregular building where we got the mushrooming column, you know, the sloping column, the abnormal column, tension beams. And then buildings are getting more complex. No? We're doing now this procedure in Rockwell about 6 towers on a common podium. Of course, the IL triangle that was just presented by Joel earlier, and then the finance center designed by Jennifer. Then, just to show you now some of our notable PVD projects, we have now the park terraces where it is actually developed by Ayala. It was the first building that uses now the buckling restraint braces now as part of the energy dissipating devices. And here I actually showed you now the picture of this VRB. Of course, as mentioned earlier, we have now the spark that is actually designed by Dana Deepskin. Very irregular building. The West Super Block, where we have now combinations of buckling restraint braces and altered wall. And then also we have this Emerald Tower, that's now the first building that we'll be using now the viscous coupling dampers. So now the locations of the BCD, and we're looking at using these dampers developed by Nippon Steel, and we're actually working with this project now with the Kinetica of the University of Toronto and also with AIT. And then there will be a NOVA project in Manila, which is after the tapering facade. And then the Sonata, again, using buckling string braces and combinations with the flag wall. The East Gallery, also BRB. And then some concluding remarks. We're saying that the Philippines has the same record risk as California, Japan, Haiti, and New Zealand. But we're saying that our practice of earthquake engineering is not up to the par as it is. C-Square taken as a challenge to elevate the practice of earthquake engineering, and it already pioneered in performance-based design approach and the use of energy-dissipating devices such as buckling restraint braces, viscous cooling dampers, as well as two liquid column dampers. We believe that we should not be bounded by the limitations of the code. We believe that we should take advantage of available powerful hardware and software in doing alternative approaches to ensure better building against earthquake. Code compliance is not enough. Innovative approach is a must. With that, I'd like to say thank you so much for your attention.